like this. Yeah. I'm going to show you this. I'll let you do it in a second. So I'm going to hold like this. He's going to push against me and take it all the way in. Once he sees his hand, he'll bend his arm perfect. Just like that. And you'll bring them together, okay?
And it just and clicks like, and
that's
clicks.
It. And you pull the down the back over top.
Yeah.
And then you get to the table, just tuck it under his. Up here and just.
I don't. Do it again.
Do it again.
Good. Yeah. So one thing you're going to do, he talked about, is you need to hang your pinkies off because you're going to have to push in like this. We'll jam that in. Start from the back.
There you go.
So just kind of follow the way he's doing his head. Turn this way so you can have to like
there you go.
Switch way. Like that. Watch this side over there. You're going to push it in. There you go. Just take your time. There you go. Now go back to the center.
Okay. There you go, put it down. I don't have
lock
to
lock it down and give it the old
coffee,
do down the side to side and make sure all the dogs
are. Alright, here's the money maker.
Hey, watch that safer.
I got this one.
I'm down.
Hey, Lauren.
Yeah.
Y'all don't need any of that foam. I got tons of it down there for you.
Copy.
BRT, obviously, the tuning it is a huge deal. Making sure you get a good beat. If it doesn't show all the way unlocked, that is not the main indicator of it being not fully unlocked. And then, so these grooves right here are keys.
Rolling stock equals torque broken or not broken?
If it's torque broken. So for the PSCS R&R, the big picture is the fail is on the P4. And this is so that we don't know why one state is that P4, the other one state is that P6.
Corroded black equals. Do you need to do this? What does this help me for if it's tethered? Then you got to get the arm over here to get that scoop off.
And then, yeah, you got to get the scoop off.
Either that or I give it to you, probably give it to you before it goes away.
Yeah, like, so if you hit...
But you got to keep the force on it and then go and be able to...
Yes. That is the problem. Okay. Some combination of all of that. But you understand the bigger picture.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so we...
My chin strap has like a big kind of cup.
There'll be two of these in this?
Yeah, probably my backup.
Okay. Pretty some of these in the...
Yes.
So these, there's already some in the bag.
Yes. So each bag for each EVA will have one of these in there.
So I should probably take one of these and stick it in the airlock to get it out of the ECOC and just have it in.
You can grab it from your bag one when you find it.
Okay. That way you've got anti-fog and lint-free paper and all these stickers and stuff that you need to get by.
Yeah.
And
the station will roughly look like this.
Yeah.
On either side. Here, just
and so you'll have to put these on the suit.
Right.
We'll probably, she's got them already. For the
and Bob, if you want to go ahead and watch anything else we can do.
That'll give you a mini workstation to go here. Let's put this tether onto the PGT.
normally, Bob?
We'll just, as long as there's one with it, we can talk about it.
And we go. Make sure you just watch your head and use the strap.
All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is a procedure that we normally don't perform because all the things, all the configuration, they have to configure the comm here on the ground. So try not to flip any switches, but this is what it would be like. Just try to imagine what it would be like otherwise.
When do we do this typically?
So like I said, this procedure you don't do standalone. The steps are captured and other procedures, making sure things are powered off and in the right config.
Oh, those cables, yeah. Like
yeah, cables. So the robot is active now. We just restrung it, so.
Okay.
Essentially, it's just 1 foot per second off nadir from the airlock.
Okay.
We had much more difficult cases last time.
Okay.
But we'll try to give you as much flying as possible today. But I did want to get to the tabletop just to show you the virtual reality trainer that you would be using on station.
Okay.
And then we may end earlier. We're booked for 2 hours, but okay. If you want to get out early just to have some more break time for your next class, since you've been back-to-back slam class.
I am going, but the sim is like
jittery.
Jumping.
Why is that? Do you see that as well? It's very laggy in your headset?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead and stop it. I know why.
5, 4, 2, 1, and you can power up.
Okay, I've turned on the safer.
We copy power up on the safer.
Waiting for it to stabilize. The attitude still definitely looks very jumpy to me. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and run with this, but I definitely feel like it's jumpy.
Copy, jumpy, VR jumpy, correct?
VR jumpy, yeah.
And what are you seeing right now?
I'm seeing the underside of space station.
Copy. EVA1 Houston, yeah, we see you passing the arm. Looking at the station cameras. Coming in at a good speed.
Copy.
All right, so. There's not a dedicated Z-book.
Okay.
Essentially, that would be part of the task list activity. We'll tell you, hey, go to the Z-book, unplug
this
equipment.
One. Okay.
That way you can plug in.
Called P2. So this USB. It is the most USBs.
Yeah, because you have a USB powering. First, you have to power an interface for the hack.
Okay. It's interesting. I can see the line in the training.